The value that you place to a meeting determines the virtue you will draw from that meeting. Hallelujah. The reason why the cripple at the beautiful gate was able to rise after many years, Acts chapter 3 and verse 5, the Bible says it's because he expected to receive something from Peter and John. I pray that your expectation will not be cut off today. Nasema matarajio ulio nayo katika conference hii hautaondoka vile ambavyo uliingia. I'd like you to raise up your hands and say, my Father, my God. I say, shout, my Father, my God. My expectation in this conference shall not be cut off. Say, my Father, my God, whatever I desire, I receive in the name of Jesus. Shout, my Father, it's my season of fullness and overflow. Patia bwana makofi na vigelegele kwa jina la Yesu. I didn't hear a shout in this house. Lunch hour, I didn't hear a shout in this house. Hallelujah. Amen. Kindly, let's take our seats. Appreciate my wonderful host one more time. Again, amen. Let's appreciate Bishop Kashengo together with Reverend Mata for the great hosting. I'm truly, truly enjoying myself here. I was blessed by a father in the nation yesterday. I also want to register appreciation to all the pastors. It's a show of humility. Kuona wachungaji wameacha kazi zao kuja katika nyumba ya Bwana, tunamshukuru. We want to welcome those that are following us online via all our social handles. The Lord bless you even as you tune in. Very quickly, because of time, I want to speak on what I've entitled positioning for a season of fullness and overflow. Position. Huyu amesema amen akaage hapa mbele. Na nyinyi mko hapa msemangi amen, murudi huko nyuma. Hallelujah. Kipata watu watatu kama hawa, injili inaweza kwenda mbali sana. Hallelujah. Positioning for a season of what? Of fullness and overflow. I'll take a teaching approach before maybe we preach at the end. But I want to say that every time the word of God is shared in any setting, either it's in a service or it's in a conference of this magnitude, every time the word of God is shared, the word of God is broken, and the word of God is preached, three things will happen. Write them down. Number one, there will be prophecies. Amen. Ndio nasikia mhubiri anasema natangaza na kutabiri. Huo ni unabii ambao unastahili upokee haraka haraka. The Bible says that that man shall not live by bread alone, but by every word that proceeded, not proceeded or will proceed, but it is present continuous tense. But whatever the man of God decrees and declares upon your life, it will come to pass. I say it will come to pass. Biblia inasema, and that Jesus is the spirit of prophecy. So apart from just you writing notes, there is a word that has been released. So the prophetic word in this season is that after this conference, you shall experience fullness and overflow. I say you shall experience fullness and overflow. I prophesy, may you see fullness. I say, may you see overflow in your ministry as a servant of God. May you see overflow and fullness in the name of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. And that is why Peter says to Jesus in Luke chapter 5 and verse 5, he says, nevertheless at thy word. Amen. Siku kamata samaki usiku mzima. Ni kama samaki wametupa toroka usiku huu. Nevertheless at your word I will let down the net. Hear me. May you become what has been declared in this conference. I don't like you, amen, today. I say, may you become what has been declared in this conference. Every vessel that come upon this altar, whatever they declare, may you receive it in the mighty name of Jesus. Lift up your right hand and say, I receive the prophetic word of overflow and fullness over my life. Hallelujah. So jambo la kwanza linatendeka kila wakati ambapo neno la Mungu linahubiriwa ni kwamba roho ya unabii inatembea mahali pale. Kwa hivyo, you will not be what you be. You will not leave this conference the way you came, because prophecy will shape your future. I say prophecy will give you a form after this conference. Number two is promises. That's why the scripture says the promises of God are yea and amen. So there is a promise upon this conference that the fullness and the overflow, it's a promise that you must see. And yesterday, Bishop gave us a scripture that all the promises that God gave to Israel, they did not fall to the ground. I pray for you. May every promise that is pregnant in this conference come to pass in your life. I say it will come to pass in your life. Shout amen. So number one is prophecy. Number two is promises. Number three is principles. Amen. Every time the word of God is shared, there are promises, there are prophecies, and there are principles. I will not dwell on the promises. I will not talk about the prophecies. I will talk about the principles. Because, ladies and gentlemen, it is principles that lay a pattern for a shift in your life. Abraham is not here, but Abraham laid a principle of prosperity. Hallelujah. God does not have to create another man, but because he laid a principle of how human beings should be created. Am I talking to somebody here? Kwa hivyo unapotazama katika Biblia, kunazo kanuni. I think kanuni is principle in Swahili. How things should be done. And that is why the Lord says to Moses, build according to pattern. Tell your neighbor, principles are pattern. No, you did not tell them. Tell them, neighbor, principles are patterns. Hallelujah. But whatever others did and they succeeded, if you do the same, you shall also succeed. Nasema Mungu ana upendeleo. Kama walifanya hivi, na Bwana akawapatia season yao ya fullness. If we align ourselves with the principle that they observed, oh, you will also record their testimony. I also say you record their results. I pray for everyone under the sound of my voice. As you do whatever our fathers did, may you receive their testimonies. Angalia jirani mwambie patterns. Hallelujah. Exodus 25 and verse 9. Listen to what God is saying. Here, 25 verse 9. Let's read 1-2 go. To me, a school fees. 1-2 go. According to all that I show you, that is the pattern of the tabernacle and the pattern of all its furnishing, just so you shall make it. He says, I'd like you to build a tabernacle, but it has a pattern. I say it has a pattern. May you be a pattern to your family. Let me try this side. May you be a pattern to your society. May you be a pattern in that town. You will be a pattern of fullness. You will be a pattern of overflow. Shout hallelujah. The same words that God spoke to Moses, he also speaks to them, to Solomon, to build according to pattern. Luke 17:32. Write them down. I have a lot of scriptures, and yet I have very little time. Luke 17:32. He says, remember Lot's wife. Kumbuka mke wa Lot. Aliangalia nyuma. Akafanyika nguzo ya chumvi. Kwa hivyo kama unataka kusonga mbele, Mary. Don't partake of that pattern. Remember her. Don't be a statistic. Don't be a specimen of those that failed like Lot's wife. I decree and I declare, by pattern you shall arrive where God wants you to arrive. Shout hallelujah. Look at your neighbor, tell them, neighbor, follow the pattern. Amen. Rebuking a lazy man, Solomon recommends a school. And he say, go to the academy of ants in Proverbs chapter 6, verse 6. And I say, matazama awana supervisor. Amen. Wewe ni mwanadam with a full dental formula. But yet God recommends a pattern from the ants. Are there people in this service that if you want to succeed, let's read together, want to go. Go to the ant, you sluggard. Consider her ways and be wise. We want to pick a pattern of a woman called Ruth, Sema Ruth. And Ruth shifted from pain and hurt and lack to become a woman of overflow and fullness. And in this sitting, maybe together with the evening, nitakuonyesha mambo ambayo Ruth alifanya. The Bible says that God is not a respecter of men, but he is a respecter of principles. If you do what, is it a Cain? Ndiye aliambiwa. Wakati alipoona sadaka ya Abel imekubalika yake imekataliwa. Akaambiwa hata wewe ukitenda mema, sadaka yako itakubalika. Wahubiri na washirika, tunapojua hivyo, hautapigana na mtu yoyote katika tauni yako. Kwa sababu kama kuna vitu wanafanya la Mungu anawabariki, God does not look at where you are coming from, but God looks at the principles that you have laid down. So from the life of Ruth, I want us to glean some few principles that catapulted her from a condition of widowhood to become the great grandmother of Jesus Christ. Wave your hand and say, I position myself for fullness and overflow. I want to highlight, quickly write them down, four conditions of Ruth before she positioned herself for fullness. Number one, she was single widowed. Single and still widowed. She had buried her husband, write it down. Buried brother-in-law and father-in-law. Amezika watu hao wote katika maisha yake. Mabibila mabwana, haijalishi ni nini umezika katika maisha yako. I see you springing forth. Your amen is standing on one leg. I say, I see you springing forth in the name of Jesus. Lift up your say, it doesn't matter what I have buried. I decree fullness in my life. Hey! Buried father-in-law, buried husband, buried brother-in-law. Number two, she had economic instability. Economic instability. Ukiona Ruth anaenda kuomba kazi, sio ya ngano, ya masalio ya ngano. Mabibi na mabwana, ni kama mtu ambaye anatafuta chakula kilichobakia. And yet, the woman that was in luck the other day, after some days, she was the owner of the whole estate. I say she was the owner of the whole acreage. I prophesy to somebody here, you shall not be a beggar forever. You shall not be a borrower forever. You are moving from zero to become a hero. You are moving from a beggar to become a lender to nations. Shout hallelujah! Yani siku ile ingine, alikuwa nangojea kile kinabakishwa kwa shamba. Lakini kwa kwa sababu ya kujiposition mabibi na mabwana. Oh, kesho yake yeye ndio aliamrisha wale wafanyikazi. I prophesy, because they did not want to pick your calls because they thought you are about to borrow again. Oh, in this season of overflow, I say in this season of overflow and abundance, God is about to turn your tables around. Shout hallelujah. Number three, what happened to her? She was a foreigner. She was a foreigner. She was in a foreign country. No father or mother or any family member around her. Yet, she became a household name. Listen, thank God for divine connection. But the greatest support you need is the support of God. I said it's the support of God. May God support you in this season. I say, may God come through for you in this season. Can I hear a shout in this house? Now from the life of Ruth, I want to show you that all these things turned around for her. Woo. Imagine, vitu vyote. What did she do to turn her life around? Number one, write it down. I think I'll give you 3 or 4 points. Then we'll be out of your way. Number one, spiritual alignment. What did I say? Spiritual alignment. She was forever changed because she connected herself with the God of the Hebrews. Hello? Remember, she was a Moabite. See the query? She was a Moabite. So she did not know the true God of the Hebrews. But when Ruth or Naomi was about to go back to her nation, and Orpah said, but me, I understand. I will go back to my people. But Ruth said, give me Ruth chapter 1, write it down. Verse 16. She said, I'm a different woman. Magada bakataya. Well, others are giving up. I can never give up. While others are going back, I can never go back. But Ruth said, can we read? Conference, let's read at the top of your voice. 1, 2, go. Yes. Yes. And your God shall be my God. She said, from today I've realized the gods of the Moabites does not work. Let me try this side in the choir. Mungu wa Moab awafanyi kazi. I align myself to the true God. I pray that out of this conference, your spiritual fire shall rise. I say, whatever is dead, it shall rise. You are moving from the gods of the Moabite. You are connecting and you are aligning yourself to the true God of the Israelites. Shout hallelujah! By the way, from this scripture, it gives us parameter for who to follow in life. Anybody that you are following must have these 3 yardsticks. Number one, where are they going? He says, where you go is where I will go. What is their vision? What is their mission in life? What is their projection in life? That is a yardstick of where they are going, of who you call. Number two, he says, your people shall be my people. What is their circle of influence? Who is their company? Who is their friends? Are there people in this service? Wave your hand and say, I position myself for fullness and overflow. Number three, who is their God? Who is their God? Kwa hivyo kabla hujafuata mtu, uliza maswali haya matatu. Number one, anaenda wapi? Number two, watu wake ni kina nani? Number three, Mungu wake ni Mungu gani? Ruth anasema, Mungu wako atakuwa Mungu wangu. Katika conference hii, ninakuombea ufike mahali ambapo utajiambatanisha na mambo ya kiroho. You will align spiritually. Overflow is not a product of carnality. Overflow is realized by pressing spiritual buttons. There are people in this service. I decree and I declare, anywhere you are lost spiritually, may you rise spiritually in the name of Jesus. Where your prayer life was nothing to write home about, let there be spiritual alignment. Amos chapter 6 and verse 1, he says, woe unto them that at ease in Zion. May you arise from your slumber. May you arise from your apathy and begin to align spiritually. Jue Mungu wa kweli. Tafuta Mungu wa kweli. Mtu mmoja aseme amen. Wacha kucheza dini. Wacha kucheza michezo ya kanisa. Amua ya kwamba mwaka huu litamtafuta Mungu na Mungu atapatikana. The Bible say, and Jotham became mighty because he prepared his ways before the Lord. James chapter 4 verse 8. The Bible say, draw nigher unto God and he will draw nigher unto you. I believe somebody will awake in this conference and decide to have spiritual alignment. Anasema nini? Nimegundua Mungu wangu wa Moab hafanyi chochote. Listen to me. You must come to a place in your life. Hear me, write it down. Faith is more than just belief. Faith is an action. Faith is an action. Bana nataka overflow. Bana nikumbuke, nikumbuke bana. Nataka overflow, financial overflow. Very good prayer. Let's go to your giving. Mumenyamaza hapo sasa. Semeni hallelujah. Baba nataka kweli, unibariki bana, unipatie pesa. Swali la kwanza. Je, fungu la 10 ulitoa mara ya mwisho lini? Huko kumenyamaza, wacha nijaribu pande huu. Hallelujah. Ile pledge ulitoa ya mwisho kanisani kwenu conference, ulilipa ama hujalipa? The other day, Bishop, I said, I think as churches and as the body of Christ, we must also come with on our own CRB report. Because kuna wapendwa wanaama kanisa paka kanisa, na ile kanisa walikuwa wa mwisho, hawakutoa pledge ya 1996. Na mtu yuko hapa anaomba Bwana ampatie overflow. There must be spiritual alignment. Semeni amen. He says, give, it shall be given back to you. Good measure, pressed down, shall God cause men to give to you. Every time you bring a seed on the altar, nifundishe hapa. Kila wakati unapoleta mbegu katika madhabahu, mbegu yako ndio itafanya Mungu aguse watu kule unakokutana na wao. So how your life proceeds and how your life, you know, continues is not determined by your grammar. It is determined by your alignment to spiritual principles. So many amen. You want God to use you mightily and you are sleeping 24 hours. You want the anointing for miracles. You want the anointing to take territories and cities. You want the anointing for exploits. But you can never fast even for 2 days. It will be something that you can never experience. Say many hallelujah. Why? Galatians chapter 6 verse 7. God is not mocked. Whatever a man sows, the same he shall reap. Amen. Wakati fulani wanafunzi wa Yesu walishindwa kutoa mapepo na wakauliza Yesu, kwa nini mapepo haya tulishindwa kutoa? Na Yesu akawaambia, this kind. Pokota pakataya. Somebody shout this kind. This kind. There is a kind of ministry you can never have without paying a price. There is a kind of an overflow and fullness that you can never contact until you lay down the price. I prophesy in this house, may you receive the grace. I say, may you receive the grace to pay the price for your spiritual fullness. Shout hallelujah.
angalia jirani mwambie spiritual alignment. Kwa nini unataka kuvuna kitu ambacho haukupanda? Hello? Look at Samson. Samson, do you know the Philistine knew this? Men of God that are here. Wafilisti walijua. Samsoni kama tutamwangusha, tutamwangusha kwa sababu tunapeana sacrifice zetu katika madhabahu. Yes. Give me Judges 16:23. I'll show you something. The Bible says when they brought Samson down, they went to their god Dagon and they thanked Dagon and they gave sacrifices, thanking Dagon for bringing down Samson. Kumbe, sio Delilah aliyeleta chini Samson. Ni alignment ya Wafilisti na madhabahu yao. Woo! Can you read the scripture? One, two, go. Loud the choir. One, two, go. Who has delivered our enemy, Samson? Is it Delilah? It is our altar. It, ladies and gentlemen, maguda bakatola bataya. Life is too deep for you to live shallowly. This life is a battle between altar versus altar. Maduka bakataza. As you are sitting in this conference, there is a business competitor that is traveling to Kitui to make sure your saloon does not function. There is a witch in your territory but wants to make sure your church will not grow. But ladies and gentlemen, by fire, by force, we rise to new levels to take territories for Jesus. Sema yes! Kila siku. Wafilisti wanaenda kwa madhabahu yao. Leo wametoa kuku 20, damu imemwagika kwa madhabahu. Baada ya mwezi mmoja wana up their game. Hawaleti kuku tena, wanaleta mbuzi. Baada ya mwezi wanaleta ngombe sasa. They are increasing the check. The Bible says it was great sacrifice that they gave. Great sacrifice. What kind of sacrifice are you giving to make sure that you are accessing your season of overflow and fullness? I say this quickly. Nothing happens automatically or accidentally in this kingdom. If you are not writing that, what are you writing? Hallelujah. Nothing happens automatically and nothing happens accidentally. Ati kanisa tu imejaa tu fwa. Ati umetoka tu kwa chini, umeenda juu. No, sir. Wakati huo, ambapo Dagon anapewa kafara, anapewa sacrifices. Do you know what Samson is doing? Bishop Gabriel, do you know what Samson is doing? The Bible says Samson is going from city to city looking for women. Ameenda Timna, ameona mwanamuke. Ameenda Soreki, ameona mwanamuke. One time I tried to Google. You know, Google is a search engine. Eh? So I tried to Google Samson and prayer. There was nothing. I said Samson and altars. There was nothing. Until Google asked me, did you mean Samson and Delilah? Are you searching Samson? The man did not have a relationship with the altar of prayer. The man did not service his altar. Ladies and gentlemen, if you don't pray, you shall become a prey to the devil. If you don't seek God, hear me. The Bible says, draw nigher unto God. Not drift nigher unto God. Draw nigher means you are intentional. Draw nigher means you have put deliberate effort. But I am going to see overflow and fullness in my life. Ya jirani mwambie spiritual alignment. Lazima kuwe na kuamua ya kwamba mimi chochote ambacho kinafanya watu wabarikiwe, watu wainuke, watu wapokee mafuta, watu wafike mahali ambapo wanastahili kufika, lazima nitakifanya. I pray for somebody here. May your altar come alive. I say, may your altar come alive. Anywhere you went down spiritually, I pray that in this conference, may you be provoked to greater heights. I say, may you be provoked to arise to new levels. Hear me, you shall not be a Samson. I say, this Philistine will not wipe you away. You are rising up in the name of Jesus Christ. Matthew chapter 1. Mark chapter 1 and verse 35. Bwana nipatie wateja. Bwana nipatie wateja. Oh Lord, give me an overflow of customers. What are you doing? What spiritual pattern are you aligning yourself? Can you read? 1, 2, go. Only pastors are reading. Please, want everybody. 1, 2, go. When he prayed, what happened? Look at verse 37. The Bible says, let's read. When they found him, they said to him, everyone is looking for you. The prayer he was praying magnetized people. The prayer he prayed pushed people to come to him. Why do you think that there will be an overflow and fullness of anything in your life without paying consumerate price? Semuseme amen. Inua mkono, sema nakata kuwa goigoi wa kiroho. When they found him, they said to him, everyone is looking for you. You want to be popular. You want to become a voice in your generation. Prayer, spiritual alignment must become portion of your life. Say many amen. Can I hear a better amen here? Spiritual alignment. So Ruth said, I know there is a God, and that God is the God of the Hebrews. Allow me to go to number 2. Write this statement down as we go to number 2. Overflow and fullness can never be achieved while doing nothing. Overflow and fullness can never be achieved while doing nothing. You must be in a position. Now listen. Ruth alipokuja kutoka Moab, bibi na mabwana, kumbuka amekuja, nimekuonyesha vitu vinne. Number 1, she's single, she's widowed, economic instability, foreigner, not support system. But when she landed in Bethlehem, the Bible says she went to the field to work. Ruth chapter 2 verse 2. She went to the field to work. Akaenda, alifika wakati wa ngano. Na kusema tu Mungu saidia wanaojisaidia. Akasema ingawa hapa nimefika, hakuna mtu wa kwetu. Na ni mahali ambapo sijui mtu yote. She asked, where is the... Can you read? 1, 2, go. Loud and clear. 1, 2, go. Number 2. Principle for fullness. Do something. Do something. Hello? Do something. It is not Naomi that said to her, my daughter, kuna shamba iko hapa nataka uende. Ni yeye mwenye alifanya homework. Akajua ni msimu wa kupura ngano. Lazima niende shambani. Hear me? If there will be overflow and fullness in your life, you must do something. Something beyond prayer. Something beyond fasting. It must be something that engages you in the physical realm. The Bible does not say, and Ruth prayed. This is not prayer. She did not go for prayer center. That is why I covered the first point, spiritual alignment. That has covered prayer, fasting, giving, whatever, holiness and purity. But this second point, roll up your sleeve and go to work. No, amen. Nasema fanya kazi, fanya kitu, ambacho kitaleta overflow na fullness katika maisha yako. Baba, nimekuachia maisha yangu yote. Umeachia Mungu maisha yako? Amekupatia maisha yako ufikirie. It is a irresponsible Christianity to leave everything in the hands of God. Hata si imani, ni ujinga. Baba, nakushukuru kwa familia yangu. Mke wangu huyu na watoto wanne nimekupatia. Yeye ndiye amewasalisha. Look at your neighbor, tell them, do something. Hallelujah. Prayer is not something you must hear me. The Bible says, the gospel that was preached to them did not profit them, did not deliver them, did not help them. Why? They did not mix it with faith. May you mix prayer with something. I say, may you mix fasting with something. Linatabiri katika ibada hii, utakuwa tajiri kwa town hii, utajenga magorofa kwa town hii, utakuwa na maploti na magari. Sema hallelujah. Gusa mtu, mwambie fanya kitu. Baba, nakungojea, nakungojea Bwana. Unapozuru wengine, Bwana usinipite. Niko hapa, unafanya kazi gani? Kazi yangu ni ya kungoja Bwana. I love the leprous men. They said, if we sit here, we shall die. If we go to the city, we shall die. Kufa plus kufa minus kufa ni kukufa. Hakuna kukufa mzuri, hakuna kukufa mbaya. Hakuna kukufa ya class na kukufa ya swag. Yote ni kukufa. We will not die here. We must rise and go. We must rise and take steps. I prophesy, you will do something in this city. I say you will do something in this city. Even if you don't see results now, continue to do it. Even if you don't see people coming up, man of God, continue to pray. Continue to teach the word. A day will come when persistence will break resistance. I say persistence. Shout hallelujah. Simama, tembelea watu watatu. Waambie, do something in this city. Tell them, do something. Nasema salimia watu watatu. Waambie, fanya kitu. Fanya kitu. Do something. Don't just sit there. Na unafikiri kanisa itajaa bila mikutano, bila crusade, bila door to door, bila open air, bila maombi, bila kesha. Na achilia neema ya kufanya kitu. Wale ambao hamuna biashara, pokea biashara kwa hii town. Wale ambao hamuna kazi, pokea kazi. Wale ambao hamuna jambo la kufanya, pokea neema. Angalia jirani, mwambie huyo Mungu namngojea. Hata yeye anakungojea. Hallelujah. Anasema whatever your hands find, take your seat. Mtu wa Mungu, kama utateka huo mji na kijiji, wezi amuka saa nne. You cannot hear me. Kanisa haiwezi kuwa kanisa ambayo inafunguliwa Sunday peke yake mpaka kufuli imeingia kutu. No. Kama ba inafungua kanisa, hata kama hakuna ibada, iwe wazi tu. Mtu mmoja ingie hapo aombe peke yake. Let's maintain spiritual fervency in that church. Hallelujah. Hata weka ushirika wa mama, ushirika wa wazee, ushirika wa vijana, ushirika wa watoto. Weka ushirika, hata kama ushirika, hata kama ni ya wa mashosho, weka. But let's make sure that something is happening. Aya. Bwana Yesu asifiwe sana. Bishop knows, by Sunday, kifika Sunday asubuhi, mimi nimesha ubiri ibada 15. By Sunday. Hallelujah. By Sunday. Amen. Morning glory wikimzima. Lunch hour wikimzima. That is why I love Nigerians. Nigerians will have every service. Eh? Fireful service. Deliverance service. Some assaulting service. Mpaka shetani anasema hapa tuondoke. Hapa lazima tuondoke. Thank you, sir. Look at your neighbor, tell them, do something. Semeni amen. Unakaa kwa biashara yako, badala ukae kwa biashara, umeenda kupiga mshene kwa watu. Paka mtu anauliza, alo, nani mwenye mpesa hapa? Hii mpesa ina mwenyewe, ndio nasema, hey, ndio mimi niko hapa. Look at useless mentality. And you are praying for overflow. And you are praying for fullness. It can never be possible. Ecclesiastes chapter 9 verse 10. Write it down. Ecclesiastes chapter 5 and verse 10. Look at this very quickly. Lando Zabagadabata. I break laziness here today. I say I break laziness here today. You will go out and do something. The Lord will give you strength to do something in the name of Jesus. Say yes. Toma. 9:10. I said 9:10. 9:10. 9:10. Let's read together. One, two, go. Whatever your hand finds to do, do it with your might. For there is no work or device or knowledge or wisdom in the grave where you are going. Stretch forth your hands. I decree your hands will be strong. I say your hands will be diligent. The Bible says the diligent hands will rule. Your hands will rule your city. Your hands will rule your territory. Your hands will feed your family. Your hands will take your children to university. Your hands will raise up a business. You'll be a millionaire in your generation. Say hallelujah. Nyosha mikono, sema mikono yangu. Pokea utele na kutiririka. Say yes. Please allow me to go to the field so that I can go and work. Yes, I came as a widow. Yes, I am lacking right now. Yes, I have no brother and sister here. But I know as I do something, something will happen in my life. As I do something, I believe that something will happen in my life. Stretch forth you and say, my Father, I position myself for fullness and overflow. Maji inatiririka. Inapotiririka, kuna mmoja atakuja na kikombe. Mwingine atakuja na ndoo. Mwingine atakuja na drum. Na mwingine atakuja na tangi ya 30,000 liters. We can never have the same harvest when our approach is not the same. When our preparation is not the same. Are there people in this service? Because of time, write point number 3. What was point number 1? Yeah? Point number 2. Point number 3, write it down. Do it seriously and diligently. Whatever you are doing, do it how? Seriously and diligently. Hallelujah. Do you have a translation called GNT? IT? GNT? Give it to me in GNT in this scripture. Let's read GNT. I'm about to close. To some GNT hapa. Lado shapa kataka ya lazita labadia. Let's read together. One, two, go. GNT. Work hard at whatever you do, because there will be no action, no thought, no knowledge, nor wisdom in the world of the dead. And that is where may you work hard. I say receive the grace to work hard. Hallelujah. Listen. One day, Boaz came to the field. I read the scripture. I see the routine of Boaz. He used to come in the morning and then leave for other businesses and maybe come again in the afternoon. So siku moja akaja mchana. Okay? Akaangalia vile wafanyikazi wanafanya kazi. Aka notice Ruth anafanya kazi. Biblia inasema akaita supervisor wake na akamuuliza, huyu mchana anafanya kazi namna hii, aliingia saa ngapi? Hello? Ruth chapter 2 verse 4. Let's go there. Aliingia sanga. Madebo godi bagataya la sataya. Hey! Kuna mwimbaji hapa, Mungu atamuinua bishop. Ataenda kimataifa. Kuna mwimbaji yuko hapa. Hivi karibuni utaingia Citizen Rauka. Baada ya Rauka unaelekea CNN. Unaelekea mataifa. Lakini hauwezi ingia kwa fullness aina hiyo kama practice unakuja kuchelewa. Mnaona hiyo amen imeishia hapo. Halo. Halo. We, Jemo uko wapi bana? Tunaanza tizi bana. Uko wapi? Na uko hapo unasema Lord make me international. The only international you will go is state. You can never go international with that kind of attitude. Read the scripture. One, two, go. Hiyo ilikuwa ni salamu ya Wayahudi. Endelea. The next verse. Yes. Who's young woman? Hear me. May you be noticed. Oh, let me try this out. I say, may you be noticed. May God distinguish you. May God separate you. Najua kuna buchari tano kwa hiyo laini, lakini yako ndio itatambulikana. Najua kuna saluni nyingi kwa hiyo laini, umeweka saluni yako. But you shall be singular. There are many churches in this city. There are many ministers in this city. But may you be noticed in the name of Jesus. May the Lord single you out. For the woman to be single, Pastor Moffat, there must be something that she did. An aura that she carried that caused her to be singled out. Semeni amen. Ai, kwani wafanyikazi walikuwa wangapi pale? Ati yeye peke yake ndiye ametambulikana. Nimekuja nikuweke mafuta ya kutambulikana. Oh, look at these people. Nasema katika waimbaji wote, wewe ndio utatambulikana. Katika washirika wote, wewe ndio utatambulikana. May the Lord cause you to be singled out. May you be separated. May you be different. May you stand out. Shout hallelujah. Who's?
Yani Mungu akupatie urembo. Mpaka hata wakati umefunga saloon. Paka unawambia nimefunga. Jane, nimefunga. Enda kwa mama shiko akusuke. Anasema hapana, tutakungojea kesho. Awatapatia mtu mwingine hiyo contract. Because wewe ndio mwenye mafuta. I love Samuel. He say we will not sit down until the boy comes. You have called him the youngest. You have painted a picture as if he's nothing. But we will not sit down. Hear me. May this generation hear about what God will do in your life. Whose young woman is this? Sasa, swali. Ni nini alifanya? 20 verse 6. Some verse 6. Let's read verse 6. At the top of our voices, I'm about to close. One, two, go. Verse 7. And she said, the reapers among the sheaves. So she came and has continued from what time? From morning until now. Eh? Though she rested much. She rested a little in the house. Hey! Tangu alipoingia kazini. Agade bakatuka pakataya. Amechapa kazi. Amechapa kazi. Nilikuambia ya kwamba Boaz alikuwa anakuja jioni. Sema amen. Sema amen. Usiniulize iko wapi. Iko kwa Biblia nilisoma. Sema amen. Na akaambiwa huyu msichana, tofauti yake na wengine ni kwamba wakija asubuhi kabla AM haijakuwa PM wameshaondoka. But this one has continued. Receive the grace to continue. Oh, this place is too quiet. I say receive the grace to continue. Receive the grace to continue. I prophesy you will continue until you arrive to your fullness. I say you will continue until you arrive at your place of overflow. Lakemea rosa kuchoka. Lakemea rosa ugoigoi. Pokea neema ya kuendelea. You will never be a former champion. You will continue. It will never be said, hey, huyu mtumishi wa Mungu 1999 alikuwa akishika microphone, uwanja mzima unaanguka. What about now? Be continue. We are quiet. Unaona huyu mzee, hii Nyeri yote ilikuwa yao, lakini sasa wana nini kiliendelea? Hawa continue. Proverbs 4:18, the path of the righteous is like a shining light that shines more and more, not less and less. You will not come from grace to grass. Look at the way you receive prophecy. I say you will not come from grace to grass. Hear me, I pray for you. The next time they see you, you will be in a higher level than where you are. I am prophesying, you are not receiving it. I say this is the last level they will ever see you in. Next time they will see you, they will see you on television. Nasema they will see you on television. Watakuona kwa magazeti. Watakuona kwa runinga. Watakuona kwa internet. Inua mikono, sema yes! From the time she came in the morning up to now, she has continued. Job chapter 8 verse 7. Though your beginning was small, but your latter end shall greatly increase. Say many amen. I said shout amen. You could be small now. You could be in a place that is not overflow, that is not fullness. But hear me. The God of Ruth, the God of Naomi, as you press the pattern, the principle of hard work and doing it seriously and doing it diligently, hey, you are about to be lifted. I say you are about to be lifted. Lift up your hand and say, Father, I position myself for overflow. Distinguish yourself with seriousness and diligence. Do you know, even those that wakati Musa, take your seat, not Musa, Yusufu, alipoleta ndugu zake Misri, nakumbuka wakati ambapo Farao alisema, oh, so you have a father who is alive, eh? Go and bring him together with all your family members. It was not guarantee that they have come to because that time Egypt was the superpower. Sindio? Egypt was the America of that time. So it was not a guarantee that every one of them will get a job. No. It was not a guarantee. If you read Genesis 47:6, Yusufu anasema, umeleta ndugu zako wote, but look for men who are hard workers. Let them keep my cattle. Not everyone. Those that are industrious. Simusome, want to go. Louder, want to go. I don't like that volume. Want to go. Yes. And if you know any competent men among them, then make them chief headsmen over my livestock. Not everyone. IT, Muko na message Bible. Weka a message Bible. Weka a message Bible. Hey. Angalia mtu mwambie amuka. Mwambie kuwa serious. Can you read in message Bible as I close? One, two, go. Egypt welcomes you. Settle your father. You are not reading. One, two, go. Settle your father and brothers on the choicest land. Yes. Give them Goshen. And if you know any among them that are specially good at their work, put them in charge. You want to be in charge? Be good at what you are doing. She has not rested. The Bible says, and Akambua, she has rested a little. Here we rest a lot. We rest a lot. A lot. We rest in the office. We rest in the house. We rest in the night. We rest during the day. Mtu yuko hapa anasema Bwana, usinipita. Alikupita kitambo sana. Alikupita. I'm telling you. Kuna mtu hapa, Reverend Mata, analala kwa ibada hii. Analala. Analala usiku. Analala kwa conference. Atalala tena jioni. Ati siesta. Siesta and you are 29 years old. 29 years old. What are you sleeping for? This sleeping, but you are sleeping everywhere, every time. Mpaka kwa sofa set umeka to pillow because you can sleep anytime. In the name of cushion. It's not cushion. It's rehearsal for sleep. Hallelujah. I pray. An army is rising in this conference. But whatever we do, we will do it with seriousness. I say we will do it with seriousness. You will never be counted among the lazy pastors. You will never be counted among the lazy ministers. Receive the grace to do your homework. Shout yes! From the time she started work, she has not rested except a little time, but she has been doing her work. He says it's not everyone that should get land, that should get work in Goshen. No, sir. No, it is those that are hard workers, it is those that are competent, it is those that are especially good at their work. Say many amen. Bwana Yesu asifiwe sana. Did I give you the testimony of this lady that was so good at her work until people paid her air ticket to go to London kusuka wa mama nywele. Hajawahi fika hapa Tanzania. Lakini kwa sababu walisuka watu nywele na yule mama karudi London na nywele imesukwa sawa sawa. Wacha hii wewe unasuka watu nywele badala ya waende nyumbani wameenda chemist kuchukua panadol. Vile umevuruta nywele yake. Vile umemusukuma. Vile anasikia kama mishipa. Ni kama itatoka. Badala aende apigwe picha ya Facebook. Amepitia kuchukua mara moja. Paka anaambia wengine musipite kwa ile saloon tena. Touch your neighbor for me and tell them, do your work diligently. Sema amen. Unafikiria watu watarudi kwa hiyo saluni tena? Nauliza, utafikiria watu watarudi kwa hiyo kinyozi tena? Kinyozi ingine watu wanapigwa marashi, wanawekwa my lotion. Yako unachukua mukia ile ilikuwa ya Kenyatta, unapiga nayo watu kichwa. Baada ya kumutu kunyoa, anatoka hapa nanuka ngombe. Anaulizwa na watoto, dadi ulikuwa kwa hori ya ngombe. Kumbe ni kinyozi ya Njoroge. Baada ya kumaliza jamaa amepigwa na ile mukia yangu. Look at your neighbor and tell them, stop mediocrity. Position yourself for fullness and overflow. Be current in your songs. Live in Nyeri, but don't allow Nyeri to live in you. Many years ago, I decided as a young man, I will package myself for a global stage. Hallelujah. Many years ago, I decided I will not look like where I came from. No, sir. Amen. That when they invite Joyce Meyer, and they invite T.D. Jakes, and they invite Apostle Junior, I will deliver. I will deliver. Some amen. Am I talking to somebody here? Angalia jirani mwambie kuwa serious. Na hiyo kitu unafanya. Hallelujah. Mtu anafanya vitu lakini hakuna seriousness. Hoteli hakuna seriousness. Munaosha hoteli saa ile watu wameingia. Customers anasema wainue miguu hivi kama cockroach. Ndio mumaliza kupiga dust. Who will come back there then? And you are saying, Lord, remember me. Overflow. Overflow. Oh, no excellence in church. There is nothing that can attract people. Amen. I said amen. No. You don't keep time. When I say, roho akitembea ndio tutamalizia ibada. Ah! Mahali roho ataenda ndio tutamaliza ibada. Na watu wamekuja na watoto. Watu wana appointment. Watu wana vitu. Ibada bado iko saa 11 jioni. Kila siku natoa watu mapepo. Kila siku. Toka. Muko wangapi? Mulikuja lini? Muko na passport? Muko na title deed? There's a quality of people that you can never get with lack of excellence. There's a quality of customers you can never attract with a degree of mediocrity. Semuseme amen. I close with Proverbs 22:29. Seest thou? He says, Proverbs 22:29. Can you read as we close? If you have been blessed, shout amen. 22:29 to some. Do you see a man who excels in his work? He will stand before kings. He will not stand before unknown men. May you do your due diligence. May you do your homework. May you become a bestseller, a reference point. Say many hallelujah. You cannot be invited for 3 times, 4 times, if you are coming to say the same thing. That is why we need to redefine anniversaries. That is why we're supposed to know, why am I celebrating 40 years? Is there anything to show that I am 40 years old in life? Ama ni kukata tu keki, keki kata. 40 years, what have you achieved? 40 years, what can we see in your life that shows us that you have lived on planet Earth 50 years? Umenyamaza kwa hiyo point. Sema amen. Kama tuwezi kuona kitu ya kucelebrate. I was telling Bishop that as we were celebrating 10 years in PMI, we can see what God has done. The churches that has been reached. I was telling him that today Redeemed, where I'm a pastor there and I'm a leader, we are celebrating 50 years. Yes, Redeemed started in 1974. Actually, this is our month of celebration, the month of June. And I'd like you to understand and to know that if PMI has achieved whatever they have achieved, all these branches everywhere for 10 years, by the time they are 50, they might be bigger than Redeemed. Celebration si kukata tu keki na kufanya mshumaa. Ni nini umefanya? Ni nani anasaidika kwa sababu ulizaliwa? Amen. Let me say this as I close. As a member, if you don't come to that church, what will we miss about you? That is your value in that church. Let me try this side. If you decide not to come to that church again, what will we miss about you? Hello? Bishop Gabriel, kuna watu ambao, their presence, their absence is equal. It's the same. Mtu akue, asikue, awe hai, akufe, asafiri, awe absent, it does not matter. I refuse to. Ama upewe soda baada ya ibada. Semeni amen. Because mpaka wewe ndio tunakwambia ni kama Kimani haukuwa Sunday. Unasema nilikuwa. Ulikuwa wapi? Nilikuwa nimeketi pale kwa kona. Because kwa kwako na kutokuwa kwako. We refuse in Jesus name. I say we refuse in Jesus name. Am I talking to somebody here? Hallelujah. I was touched, is it 7 or almost 10 years ago? Bishop Nyarieko is coming here, he's one of the speakers. But several years ago, Bishop Nyarieko was preaching in South Africa. And as he was preaching in South Africa, something terrible happened. The place where they were leasing was KFA. Okay? So they gave him notice. They gave notice to the church when he was not there. He's in South Africa. So there was confusion, there was pandemonium. He has not finished his mission. And yet, he is supposed to, the church will locate, wameleta makatapila, kuangusha kanisa. Hajua taenda wapi. He called me, and he said, man of God, I'd like you to run to our church, because you are the person that I know. If my members see you, they will be encouraged. He said, the relationship that I built with you, and the way our members love you, when they know it is Pastor Junior coming, the place will be encouraged. As I organize myself to come, please go and stand there. Nikasema kai, kumbe niko na thamani kwa hii dunia. Ala? Kumbe naweza kwenda kutia watu moyo. Mahali wamevunjika moyo. Kumbe naweza kutegemewa katika hii dunia. May you position yourself for overflow and position. Give me the scripture in NLT. 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 Shada baba baba ya sata. NLT. NLT, we close. Let's read one to go. Do you see any truly competent workers? They will serve kings rather than working for ordinary people. The last one, write it down. The last point, write it down. What was point number one? What did Ruth do to merit her overflow and fullness? Number one. Number two. Number three. The last one, write it down. Do it with godliness. Do it with godliness. Don't be a crook. Godliness. Godliness. Ungu. Don't be a crook. Usiwe jambazi. Usiwe muongo. Usiwe mtu wa shortcut. Hapo mmenyamaza sasa. Hello. Your integrity must be high. Your character must be high. Wacha watu wajue. Chakula yako ya hoteli yako ni fresh. Na kama ni ya jana, utasema ni ya jana. Hey. Aba hawataki kuniangalia. Look at verse 10. Ruth chapter 2 verse 10. If you want overflow and if you want fullness, there must be character and there must be integrity. So me want to. Did I say Luke? No, I said Ruth. Ruth 2:10. Let's read one to go. So she fell on her face, bowed down to the ground and said, have I found favor in your eyes that you should take notice of me? Since I'm a foreigner. Next verse, look at verse 11. Want to go. And Boaz answered and said to her, it has been fully reported to me all that you have done for your mother-in-law since the death of your husband, and how you have left your mother, father and your mother and the land of your birth, and have come to people. So many amen. Galia jirani muambie habari zako zinaenea. It was reported to me. Your character has been reported to me. Your demeanor has been, the way you conduct matters. There's a place whereby he says that you have kept yourself away from young men. Remember the place? So Boaz said, tumekupima, tumekuvet, wapendwa, watu wanakupima. Umenyamaza. Hallelujah. Uyo kijana ni mzuri, anapiga keyboard kweli. Jamaa vidole vyake vimepakwa mafuta. Lakini mchunge na wadada. Sio wewe my son, it's not you. Angalia jirani mwambie ripoti yako imefika. Hello? Ile hoteli ni mzuri kweli. Lakini chakula ya juice. Fulani alikuwa kule akaendesha. Fulani, it was reported to me. Listen to me. Your name, your character will go before everything else. Joseph is interpreting dream for butler and baker. Have I blessed somebody here today? And the Bible says, Pharaoh says to him, I have heard about you. Tell your neighbor, they have heard about you. Wamesikia. Kwamba ukienda kwa yule saloon, utatoka hapo uende chemist. Genesis 41 verse 15. Stand up on your feet. We close with that scripture. Positioning yourself for overflow and fullness. And this girl that came widowed, and this girl but came economical and stable, and this girl but came with nothing. Can you read this scripture? We close. Tusimame kila moja. Tusimame, nimepeleka muda mbele kidogo, but I just want you to read very quickly. One to go. Loud, I want to go. And Pharaoh said to Joseph, I have had a dream, and there is no one who can interpret. But I have heard it said of you, but you can understand a dream to interpret. I pray for somebody in this service. May men hear about your ministry. I say, may men hear about your business. May men hear about your exploits. I prophesy, even as I close, the Lord will cause your name to be known. The Lord will cause your name to be heard. You will not be numbered among the mediocres. You will not be numbered among those that are playing. You will be numbered among those that are serious. Raise up your hands, Lanzawa, and begin to tell the Lord, I position myself for overflow. I position myself for fullness. Inua mikono na sauti mwambie Bwana, napokea kile ambacho nilikosa. Napokea kile ambacho sikuwa nacho. Napokea kile ambacho sijakuwa nacho. Oh, peace root that came as a widow. Peace root that came with a broke and a lacking girl. She was lifted to new heights, and she became the great grandmother of Jesus Christ. Listen to me. I pray for everyone here today. But your story will not end the way you are today. I say your story will not end the way you are today. The way God elevated Ruth and brought her to a place of overflow. May the Lord bring you to a place of overflow. Please take me as we stand. Take me to Ruth chapter 2 and verse 9. I show you four things that turned around in the life of Ruth. I showed you four that was a disadvantage, but look near here. Ruth 2:9. We close here. One to go to some. To some, one to go. Thirsty, go to the vessels and drink from what the young men have drawn. That is a season of fullness in our life. That is a season of overflow. Listen, number one, she received a stable place to get food. Yule mtu alikuwa naomba omba juice, akaingia maali pa overflow. She was told, let your eyes be on the field wherever they reap and go after them. There shall be no poverty in your house. I don't like your amen. There shall be no lack in your house. You shall be a lender to nations. You shall not remain a tenant forever. You shall not be a beggar forever. You shall be an employer of labor. In the mighty name of Jesus. Number two, she was protected from harassment of men. The Bible says, have I not commanded the young men not to touch you? Hear me. 1,000 shall fall on your left and 10,000 on your right. No weapon formed against you shall prosper. In this our season of overflow, you are becoming a touch not. I say you are becoming a touch not. God has commanded his angels to protect you from men, from witches, from those that harass other people. I prophesy you are protected. Inua mikono sema, I am protected. Sema, I am protected in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. The last one. Sikiliza. Watu wanakufa na ajali Kenya hii saa hii. The Lord has commanded. The young men will not touch you. The Lord has commanded. Premature death will never touch you. I say the Lord has commanded. You will have fullness of your days. He said, with long life shall I satisfy you. That is overflow of life. Fullness of life. We refuse premature death. In the mighty name of Jesus. The last one. And when you are thirsty, go to the vessels and drink from the young men have drawn. Number three, what she received. Water to drink when she was thirsty. Overflow and fullness. Overflow and fullness. And of course, you know the story that she was married by Boaz and she became strategically placed to become a great grandmother of Jesus Christ. A Moabite became a Hebrew by adoption. Can I pray for you? This city will hear what God has done in your life. I say this city will hear what God, who is this young woman? And the supervisor said, Master, this lady has been working since morning until now. And when she rested, it was very, imagine if Boaz would have come and missed her at her workstation. Imagine if Boaz would have come and was told this lady alikuwa hapa tu na ameondoka alienda hata hajapeana report hata hajasema ameenda nyumbani. She would never have positioned herself to a place of overflow. Si upokee kile ambacho unahitaji. Si upokee kile ambacho unahitaji. Inua mikono, my Father, my God, position me for overflow. Position me for fullness. Let me have spiritual alignment anywhere where my prayer life, my giving life, my holiness, my purity, my passion, my commitment is dead. Revive me again, O Lord. Father, where the enemy has shaved my hair, maali delaila na wafilisti wame nyoa nywele zangu, Bwana ninaomba, revive me again. Revive me again. Give me the grace to do something. Put down your hands. Listen. Another woman that we will look maybe the evening or tomorrow is the Samaritan woman. She came to the well with a pot, but she left with a well of living waters. Alikuja na ndoo ya kuteka maji, lakini akaiwacha pale kwa sababu aliondoka na overflow, na fullness. But this was the catchment. She was told by Jesus, give me your water. I'll be able to give you my water. He says, buy from me pure gold. What is gold? Gold is a property of royalty. So for you to receive the level that you want to go, there must be a price for you to pay.
Tufunge macho yetu. Tuinamishe vichwa vyetu. Uko mahali hapa na hujaokoka. Na hujamjua Yesu kuwa Bwana na Mwokozi wa maisha yako. Na unasema mimi nataka niwe Ruth ambaye alikuwa Moab, kabila ambalo limelaaniwa. Lakini baadaye akakumbatia Mungu wa Naomi na akatoka ndani ya kukosa, ndani ya widow na ndani ya kukosa watu wao, na akafanyika mama wa utele na mama wa baraka. You could be in this service. You just came because you understood through announcements that there is a lunch hour going on here, or a friend invited you, but you are saying, Apostle Junior, pray for me so that I can be restored and I can be navigated to the place of my fullness and overflow. Unataka kuokoka ama ulikuwa umerudi nyuma na ungependa kumrudia Yesu kama Bwana na Mwokozi wa maisha yako? Will you raise up your hand wherever you are standing? Raise up your hand. Inua mkono wako mahali popote umesimama. Usione haya, usione aibu. Yesu anasema yeyote atakayenionea haya katika dunia hii, na mimi nitamuonea haya mbele ya Baba yangu mbinguni. Usione haya. Moab kuona haya. Ruth alijua amepoteza vingi, lakini kama atafanya vitu hivyo vinne ambavyo nimekuonyesha, atainuka. Na wewe kama utaamua kuacha miungu ya Moab na kumkumbilia Mungu wa Ebrania ambaye alikufia msalabani, unaweza kusaidiwa mchana wa leo. Anybody here? Inua tu mkono wako. Haijalishi umesimama wapi, ushers watakutoa mahali popote ulipo. And the Lord will bless you in Jesus' name. Salimia watu watatu and tell them, position yourself for fullness and overflow. Salimia watatu. Amen. Hallelujah. Take your seat. I'd like us to package an offering. An offering that says, I am doing something. I am doing something to experience financial overflow. To experience financial fullness.